Education Committee. First bill?
Senate Bill 33A by Senator DeFrancisco would modify the cap on BOSI superintendent salaries to recruit better candidates.
Second.
Any opposition? Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 248B by Senator Martins would allow schools to provide transportation to students living within 2 or 3 miles of the school.
Any opposition? Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 2536 by Senator Ritchie would allow not-for-profits health and dental clinics to operate in the school.
Move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 2968 by Senator Funky would require that any state mandate imposing a cost upon a school district may not be imposed until after the adoption of the school budget.
Move the bill.
Any discussion?
We have a negative vote from Senator Montgomery.
Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 2969 by Senator Funky would allow school districts, except for New York City, to sell advertisements on their athletic facilities.
Move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 3655 by Senator Funky would provide students an opportunity to take Regents exams if they missed it due to school closure.
Move the bill.
Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 4656A by Senator Lanza would require the Commissioner of Education to reschedule any canceled Regents exams within 20 business days.
Move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 5804A by Senator Serino directs the Commissioner of Education, in collaboration with the Commissioners of Health and Environmental Conservation, to develop instructional tools and materials to assist in the education and awareness to protect children from Lyme disease and tick-borne infections.
Move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 6506 by Senator Marcelino would provide flexibility to school districts in celebrating Earth Day and teaching about the Earth's environment.
I move the bill. We have two AWRs, myself and Senator Hamilton.
Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 6851 by Senator Lavelle would extend until June 30th, 2018, allowing certified school psychologists to conduct screenings for children under 5 for a disability.
Move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 6930 by Senator DeFrancisco.
Top of the page, yes.
Would allow the City of Syracuse and the Syracuse City School District to refinance bonding related to the Joint School Construction Board.
Also move the bill.
Any discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7217 by Senator Marcelino would include special education schools outside of public and BOSI schools within the fingerprinting and criminal history record checks of employees.
Move the bill.
Second.
Any discussion?
This is 7217?
Yes, it is.
We have a no vote from Senator Montgomery.
Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7299 by Senator Funky would provide transportation aid forgiveness to districts that would otherwise lose aid due to inadvertent, minor, and technical errors.
Move the bill.
Second.
Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7496 by Senator Marcelino would create a grant program to support PTEC and early college high school programs with a funding level of $25 million. This is the Department of Education departmental bill.
Move the bill.
Second.
Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7554 by Senator Marcelino would create a fingerprinting system similar to New York City's that allows for providers of support services to schools to quickly confirm the safety of their employees.
Also move the bill.
Second.
Discussion? Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7611 by Senator Marcelino would include licensed mental health counselors, licensed marriage and family therapists, licensed psychoanalyst, and licensed creative art therapist within those certified to be hired by school districts. This bill will be reported to the Higher Education Committee.
Motion to move the bill. Second.
Discussion. Bill is reported.
Senate Bill 7626 by Senator Marcelino would enhance privacy protections to students' personal identifiable information maintained by schools and school districts and require the notification of parents and guardians of the privacy policy and how the data will be used by the school.
Bill. Second.
Any discussion? Bill is reported. And that ends the agenda. And maybe Mr. Chair, I'm sorry, Mr. Hill.
Yes, General. I just wanted to just put something out there as far as education and technology in our schools. We have a lot of jobs that require computer technology, and in my district, I have computer labs, and no one able to teach computer technology to kids as far as coding. So, Chairman, I would ask in the future, look into enhancing our computer technology in our public schools, because there's a lot of jobs out there that our children are missing out.
Well, there is a program that has been established, and we did a press conference just the other day with Chancellor Zimfer and of SUNY and Chancellor Elia from State Ed. It's called Teach New York. It is designed to pick up and increase the number of teachers licensed in various areas, and specifically in areas that are underserved, where we need more teachers and to go out and make an outreach for these people. So that's already been, is on the minds of the leadership of State Ed and SUNY. They're well aware of that, because most of our teachers, frankly, are trained by SUNY. And they're looking to, expand their training program and reach out to young people who would like to come into the teaching profession to try to get them in here. But there is right now a tremendous competition, because if they are trained in the kind of skills you're talking about, there's tremendous competition in the private sector for them.
Correct, I agree.
And they can earn, in many cases, a lot more money than they can get in the school systems. So we have a long way to go and an outreach to make, but SUNY and State Ed is well aware of, as are we, well aware of the situation. But I thank you for bringing that up. Meeting is adjourned. Are they finished upstairs?